Going on, everybody. Anthony here, AD Studio. And basically tonight I'm going to be continuing part two of what I was working on yesterday, which was this particular interior page here. This girl falling out of a high level window. And she is using some of her powers right now. And that's as vague as I'm going to keep it. So let's get to work. I'm going to dim the lights here. I left off, I was drawing the cityscape here. So we turn up the brightness here. There we go. It's going to be a lot of noodle work tonight. Hope everybody's having a good weekend, having a good Sunday. And when I get done with this piece, I guarantee
you. You're going to love my nuts.
So when I first started and I got the stream deck, I think I had like a total of maybe like three different sound effects. Kind of went through before starting here tonight and kind of added a bunch to it. Yeah, some of my favorite TV quotes, this and that. Probably be changing it out as we go along. A lot of noodling work tonight. It's gonna be a lot of drawing a fuck ton of squares and lots of black areas. Let's see if I can knock this out, hit it hard and fast.
That's what she said.
I love that shit. I swear my shit gives me a fucking coronary sometimes. It says I'm not online, or not live, and then I'm looking right at the video being streamed live right now. Get my glove on real quick. Pretty neat so far. Got some tendrils and shit down here too. Crazy effect. That symbiote looking effect. Sure does look awful dark on the screen, doesn't There we go. I'm gonna kind of rough this out. I'm gonna be going back over it with my watercolor brush, loaded up with some graphite. That way everything looks kind of clean and cohesive. It's looking pretty red so far. too crazy in detail down here. It's going to be a shit ton of like glass coming out anyway. I'm actually going to leave this corner kind of open to interpretation. Hey Sean, how you doing, buddy? Ladies and gentlemen, Sean Pottle.
Looks like I picked the wrong week. Quit sniffing glue.
Glad to hear. Going on the weekend, you got a Monday through Friday job. You gotta go back tomorrow morning, like me. Yeah, I got a wild idea here. This isn't just to save myself trying to not draw a bunch of shit, but I want to do like a massive propaganda video over here. So, in the story, in this realm of the world right now, the Changeling has pretty much possessed a good chunk of people. I almost say borders on human domination. And of course, it's done through the means of propaganda. And it's a world with these massive video screens here. So I got all these tinny ones. I want a big ass one. There we go. Got kind of a makeshift video screen here. Get some weird wires and shit. So Sean, I got an existing photo in the cityscape here. Kind of manipulated it a bit before kind of going over it here. Yeah, you know, just that way I can get this picture of this chick kind of falling out of a window here, kind of like Michelle Pfeiffer in Batman Returns. So I gotta draw a lot of monotonous architecture here. my hand hurts.
I'm a drug.
So you play a lot of racing games at all, Sean? What are some of your favorite games there? It's funny, I'm actually going to be trying to jump back and finish Cyberpunk 2077 here in the next couple of days. But only when I feel like I've actually earned some fucking downtime to play it. Oh, right on. The worst fucking genre that I can play. I'm fucking ass at any first-person shooter. The only first-person game I think I can actually say I'm decent at would be, like, Shadowgate 64. They can't aim for shit. Even, like, Cyberpunk is, like, kind of a fucking slog sometimes. Have you played the new Gran Turismo 7 yet? Been on the fence about it. I've been seeing people talking like a massive amount of shit about it. And I don't think they have a PC port for it, obviously, so. I remember you said you're a PC guy. I did download the newest Need for Speed on Steam. That game was pretty rad, but man, like, I feel like it's been like 3 days of like tutorials before you can even like fucking do anything. I do love that Need for Speed keeps those cheesy ass, like, cutscenes, you know, it's really bad. They're fucking terrible. But, like, they work so well for that game. Is that what you're playing now? Battlefield 1? Yeah, the best way to play those racing sims is definitely with a steering wheel. I got one for my PS4. I play GT Sport on it. Like, I'm not even really concerned with even trying to get the new Gran Turismo. It's got all that always online bullshit. And not that Need for Speed's any better, but, you know, just annoyances. The Chivalry, I haven't heard of that one. Oh shit, that sounds rad. Like a fighting game like Tekken and Mortal Kombat? Or like a strategy type fighting game? Oh, okay. Like a third-person medieval game. Right on. I think it'd be fucking badass if they'd like made like a game like that. But like you play as like Ronnie James Dio. For, like, the Holy Diver music video. And you just go around and kill people just by showing them, like, your metal horns and shit. That'd be fucking rad.
That's the joke.
Okay, light this motherfucker up. Alright, so I gotta finish off this block back here. I think I can kind of cheat here. You mean like Attack of the 50-Foot Changeling? The fuck, did I run out of lead on both? The thing with the Changeling is that the bigger she gets, she turns into a vile-looking creature. Right on. All right, let me reload my ammo real quick. So if you're into that kind of stuff too, like giant women kicking ass, like in cityscape settings and stuff, you should check out Mount Olympus Comics. My buddy Ron Zabala, he does a book there called Valkyrie Saviors. And it's like these, I haven't quite read it to be honest. I print all of his books and stuff. I've kind of flipped through it. I'm kind of guilty of not really being up to code on everything that I print for everybody. But it's about like these I won't say they're Greek goddesses or whatever, and they turn into like these 50-foot versions of themselves. Pretty neat. Dude does pretty good for himself with Kickstarter and everything, too. I think his last one, he made like $125,000 or something like that. So there's definitely a following in a fandom there. You might dig it. Figure out how to make it more interesting, because I would just probably just size them up. I probably have to do something a little bit more storyline heavy. Alright, let's see what we got behind her head real quick. I could probably leave it as is. All right, I think we're at for now. All right, so I'm gonna tape this all back off. And I think I have to prep my my brush marker. All right, so I got to paint some glass. And then kind of paint over, if you look right here in this spot, you can kind of see how smooth the graphite is versus like all the stuff I've been painting. We're going to kind of course correct that here real quick. All right, so my smaller marker is good. I think I just need to take care of the big boy here. So I'll be right back. I need to go grab some water real quick. I got a soda too. All right, so I'm going to mix a little bit of watercolor in here. secondary. You kind of see like the faint watercolor effects. I haven't really added too much graphite on it. Supposed to be like a giant audience full of people down here. A little bit. Funny with being able to play music while doing this, like in my headphones, and not really having easy access to change the song. I get to listen to some weird shit on my playlist. There's a band called Ween. They did that song called Where'd the Cheese Go? For a Pizza Hut ad that was never used. And then they did a remix called Bitch, Where's the Motherfucking Cheese At? So that's what's playing in your headphones right now. Bitch, Where's the Motherfucking Cheese At? Oh, the fun burps my mouth is making right now. John, what are you up to tonight? This blast is so fucking fun. Greetings, new viewer. You're having a good Sunday yourself? Oh, that glare. So it's terrible. Right on, man. Like, I've been doing that like all morning. I've been watching like a shit ton of like Review Tech USA streams. Guy's fucking hilarious. And then lots of napping today too. I think I'm reasonably happy with this. I just gotta draw the top panel. The actual jumping out of the window scene. All right, and it's a shattered window. Alright. It's good to me. A random question. Can you hear the Tourette's guy when I push this button? Yeah! Just wondering, because for some reason it keeps cutting out, like in my monitor. But I'm not sure why. I was asking if you can actually hear the Tourette's guy when I push this button. Yeah! I don't know if you heard that. It's him going, shit! But for some reason, it doesn't pick up on my my monitor, but it shows it's playing. Oh, okay, cool. Well, something's funky with my monitor. Fucking love that guy, Tourette's guy. Let's dim the lights. Move this up here a little bit. Like a fucking glass explosion right here. Ah, hand cramp. Fuck. All right, so this one's easy enough. I'm gonna probably end up taking out the underneath image tracing that I did. couple more guidelines to draw, and that's it. There we go. But what I wanted to do with this page is I wanted to kind of illustrate just how small she is in the grand scheme of things here. What's up, Lucy Cat? She's wanting to play with that drawing there. Spoiled ass cat. There's going to be more or less silhouettes here. So I want to do like this really cool kind of silhouette effect because I want this screen, this giant Changeling tribute screen, to be right behind her. I'm gonna draw some cityscape type stuff right there too. Right, so keep this all back up. Oh, I'm gonna be so fucking happy if I pull this shit up. It'll look good on a solid page. When I gave this one a sort of vignette when I started. Have some stark black on both sides here. Take my watercolor brush. Add some heavy graphite to it. A little bit of water flow going. Just shot out on my arm. How cool is that? Look at that. I think I might have jammed this one up good. So in order for that glass effect to really pull off, I'm going to need to paint these windows here. Put the lid right here. What the fuck is going on, Anthony? What did you just do? If I look at him, I make it go. Oh! There's a reason for it. Probably remove the tape now. Almost wrapped up here, guys. I think I'm done for tonight, guys. I think I got my page here. Yeah, it's some text over that anyway, so. Draw out the outlines real quick. Call it a night. Thanks, Sean. We'll scan it in and then show everybody a little bit here in a little bit here. That way you can see it without the glare and all that shit. Who's ready to see it? I want to put it on the big screen here. Okay. Wait, she's gonna punch me right now. Hi there. So, here is a better look at the finished pages here. Yeah, I can't get that glitter away to save my life. So I'm going to throw a photo up on Facebook here in a minute. Give it a little likey-loo there. And I'm going to call it a night, guys. Thank you, Sean. Good hanging out with you again, like always. And I'll see y'all around. Y'all have a good night.
I'm a drunk. I don't know nothing about how I do anything.
Oh!